Will this election be a referendum for President Trump's political capital?
I'm sure some of the people nationally will make that kind of a view of it, but I think it's really a referendum on the direction of Virginia. The governor of Virginia really can set a good agenda or a negative one for the state. And I, as chairman, honorary chairman of Ed Gillespie's policy ideas, he has some really great ones to make Virginia more competitive for investment and jobs with lower taxes and regulatory reform and productive energy policy. And to the extent any of those issues fit in with what's going in Washington, I think you could say that will be a referendum. I think Virginia, Shery, as you know, voted for Hillary Clinton by about 5 or 6% of the vote over President Trump. Ed Gillespie is going to do great in the areas that Donald Trump did well in, and his opponent will do well probably in most of the areas that Hillary did well. But there are certain policies that have been put into effect, regulatory reform in Washington, productive energy policy, and ending the sequester, which allows our military to strengthen. And that matters from the coal fields to our ports and also in the Hampton Roads area, where there's a, you know, the military and military readiness and defense contracting is vitally important. So that's a big plus for Ed Gillespie.
Governor, no question that the military is terribly important in the state of Virginia, but a lot of things you just talked about are really federal issues. Let's talk about what's being talked about on the campaign trail. What we are hearing a lot about, and maybe it's inaccurate, is talk about Confederate statues and whether they should come down or not. Things like sanctuary cities, of which I understand there are none in Virginia. Why is Mr. Gillespie spending so much time talking about those things rather than the real meat and butter things you're talking about?
Well, on the Confederate memorials, that is obviously everyone is watching the despicable neo-Nazis in Charlottesville and at the University of Virginia. And that came up, obviously, you cannot talk about that without disparaging and in fact, condemning those white supremacists and neo-Nazis. And Ed Gillespie did. Then it got to this whole thing about removing Confederate memorials, and his opponent said, remove them all. And Ed said, no, as part of heritage, put a context to it. On the sanctuary cities issue, in Northern Virginia, there's this gang violence, this MS-13 group, and there's been 8 murders just in the last year, which is bad. And so Ed's addressing that because law enforcement is ultimately one of the top responsibilities of a state government, along with education. And so, and there's a difference of opinion in the two of them. Now, what the Democrats have done, though, with this pickup truck ad is that's really fired up Republicans. To me, that is a fumble. And it's a question of whether Ed Gillespie will get a field goal and plus 3 points or 7% with a touchdown. And I think it's really, in this last week, has energized people for Ed Gillespie with an ad that they even had to take down because it was so awful.
There's no question that the political climate right now is very, very charged. So not surprising, Gillespie has been sort of keeping a distance from President Trump. However, if you take a look at this map that we want to bring up, Gillespie, when he ran for Senate, failed in 2014. He did pretty well in the northern side of Virginia versus where President Trump did well in the 2016 election south of Virginia. So how well could this tactic work when he's continuing to keep his distance from the president?
Well, I think to some extent the North and the Democrats have drawn all the ardent Trump supporters to Ed Gillespie by blasting Donald Trump all the time, calling him a narcissistic maniac, and I'll not repeat all the things they've said. The turnout, Shery, this year will not be as big a turnout as there is in a presidential election. When I ran for governor, we had the record high turnout, over 61%. The last election for governor, 2013, had the lowest at 43%. From what I heard at my precinct, and I have voted near Mount Vernon, they said it's a good brisk turnout and it should be higher than it was last year. So Northern Virginia in a presidential race is about 35% of the vote in Virginia. In a governor's race, it may be 33%. You say, well, that's only 2%. Well, I think this election is going to be that close. And so 2% difference might matter, and the Democrats are trying to energize their base. We're trying to energize ours. And the key in Virginia, by the way, are independent voters. people who pay taxes, work for a living, care about their families, but they don't care about red versus blue. They care about who has the best ideas. And those are the ones who are going to make this ultimate be the fulcrum of making this decision. And I'm optimistic that they're going to go with Ed Gillespie.